Mike Sheffer here, 3 weeks out. Just wanted to do a morning weigh-in with you guys. So if my scale ever works, I will show you. I'm gonna show you with the camera. So it was 173.2 this morning, but my camera apparently weighs 0.5 pounds. So that's it. We're in a new low right now. So a quick little conditioning update. Feel pretty damn good right now. The last competition I did that I was 3 weeks out, I was feeling really depleted and tired and exhausted. And I think one of the main reasons why I'm feeling so much better this time is obviously the cut has been much, much slower. So my body is not as fatigued and exhausted because it's been a slow progression. And then the second thing is the vitamins and minerals I've been taking during this prep and leading up to it. So I'm gonna show you guys exactly what I'm taking in hopes that maybe it helps you with your prep. Got my egg whites as usual cooking on the stovetop. 1.5 cup of egg whites, 3 eggs, 1/2 cup of oatmeal, blueberries, and I'm putting ketchup and sriracha on the eggs. Today we're getting an arm workout in, doing a whole bunch of posing. 3 weeks out, I still haven't done any preparation for my classic physique routine yet. So I think that today is probably a great day to start thinking about that because we're 3 weeks out. Got my posing trunks for classic physique. The physique posing trunks are still getting made. They will be ready next weekend, I believe November 4th. So you'll be seeing those in the 2 week out video. Stay tuned to those. The color is amazing. It's gonna look great. There it is. 1.5 cup of egg whites, 3 eggs, ketchup, sriracha, blueberries, oatmeal, coffee. We got it. And check this out, guys. We got an amazing day ahead of us. Super stoked about this. I think everybody on prep can relate to this. I'm always amazed at how fast I can eat my food once I start dieting. So the vitamins that I take in the morning, I take 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C. I guess I wouldn't really call this a vitamin, but fish oils. So I take 4 of these, and they have 300 milligrams of omega-3s. And then I take flaxseed as well. These ones have, it's 1,000 milligrams of flaxseed oil. And the breakdown is 450 milligrams alpha-linoleic. I'm just gonna show you guys the label because I clearly can't see it. You see it? Oh, focus. There you go. And then I also take the dreaded, or not, depending on who you are, apple cider vinegar. Let's try to zoom in on this one. Focus. If you guys have not, there you go. If you guys have not tried this stuff yet, I think it's a very worthwhile investment. It has prevented me from being sick when I feel like I'm getting sick so many times. It has helped my digestion. And I feel like because it's helped my digestion, that it's actually helped me lose weight or lean bulk. Like when I was, I've been taking apple cider vinegar now for at least 6 months. So ever since I started taking it, and I don't know if it's just a complete coincidence, it could be, but ever since I started taking it, and I take, I'm doing it in a wine glass, this is hilarious, but I take about that much with my morning meal and right after my my dinner. So ever since I started taking it, I've just noticed like much less body fat stored on me, better energy levels, and I think this shit is the real deal. I know that a lot of people talk about it and it seems like sort of a fad and it tastes like absolute shit, but you get used to it and I think it actually works, so go check it out. Kidding. Okay, so we're all ready for the gym. Another thing I do in the mornings is I roll out my thoracic spine, which is the upper spine. So from approximately here in your back up to here. The reason I do that is because us as bodybuilders and just human beings in general, we're always internally rotated. Our chest pulls on our shoulders and rotates them forward, which creates a whole bunch of tension in the front of our bodies and a whole lot of elongation in the back. So what we do is we release that tension in the spine, and it's gonna allow us to stand up a little bit straighter, and it's gonna allow us to open our chest up, and overall it's just gonna be better for our posture. So I have my roller on the ground. I'm just gonna roll for about 4 or 5 minutes and just really, really slowly release the spine. All right, we're on our way to the gym. Got my car carbs. Today's a low carb day, so it's just 3 rice cakes before the gym and 3 rice cakes after. Then I had my half cup of oats. So I think the total net carbs is around like 150 for the day. Good morning, everybody. Just woke up, getting my breakfast in. I'm gonna put the ketchup and sriracha on real quick. Oatmeal's in the microwave, getting ready to go. Those are the pizza box remnants from yesterday. We got meal prep today, so I got my chicken breasts. They were buy one, get one free, so I got two of them. Got my steaks, asparagus, and broccoli. That's the main things that I meal prep. That's how I find I do it the easiest. My carbs I get from oatmeal in the morning and from rice cakes around my workouts. That way it keeps it real easy for me to stay on track, especially when I'm like on the go all the time. I was supposed to have my cheat meal today, but as you can see, pizza boxes from yesterday. We worked out like three times yesterday. Went in the morning, trained arms, did posing, probably spent, I don't know, 3 hours at the gym. Then we went to the field after that and we're doing sprints, and we were probably there for about an hour, which I am sore as hell from right now because I haven't sprinted in a long ass time. But it's good because it brings out my hamstrings, fast twitch muscles, gets them firing, and hopefully we can dial my hamstrings in by the show. The next thing we did was we went to West Coast Iron again to do some filming for the website. We were there for about another hour. So we were just so exhausted that we had to have a cheat meal. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is the chicken. I'm super picky with my chicken. So I literally go through it and I cut out all of like the chewy stuff and the fat on it. It is what it is. I use scissors actually. It's way faster and safer than using knives. I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. So chicken breast, you see, it's like that. Flip it over, you got this piece here. All this shit in here, that is gonna make your chicken super chewy. So I take the scissors and I go through it and I cut out all those little pieces that look like that, because I like to be able to eat my chicken without having to chew on it like crazy. If you do that, your chicken is gonna taste like 100 times better, I promise you, and you're gonna be able to eat it and it's not gonna be like... All right, seasoning for the chicken. So once the chicken is all prepped, ready to go, looks clean, looks good, what we want to do is cover it in olive oil. You only need like three things to season chicken to make it taste amazing. I'm telling you guys, this is the key. This one right here, if you can see it, it's Garlic Plus, it's called. Signature Clubhouse Garlic Plus. Use that one. And then add this, which is Cajun spice, and just cover the thing in garlic first and then Cajun spice. It'll taste freaking amazing, I'll tell you. Olive oil's on it. I just sort of flip them around and make sure that they're all coated with olive oil. That'll help the spices stick to it. So you don't put spices on it, it just goes right back on the plate. It's a little bit hard right now to film while trying to keep my hands not covered in chicken. Okay, so we're gonna go garlic plus first. Check it out, garlic plus. Cajun. Okay, now flip them over. Same thing. Garlic. Cajun. They are ready to go. Now, of course, The one time I try to show you guys how I'm gonna barbecue, the freaking propane is out. But luckily, we have a solution. I got this extra propane bottle here, which I think is full. Let's just turn it off first. It's for a fireplace we have upstairs, an outdoor fireplace. So I'm gonna need two hands for this. No, maybe not. Yeah, it feels full. Okay. Oh, maybe not. Maybe this one's empty too, that would suck. All right, I'll wait till it's about 4 to 450. Look at that grill, we're ready to go. Try to put them the big ones at near the back because the back's hotter. Small near the front. Probably the worst cameraman in the world. There you go. Look at it. Got another beautiful day ahead of us. Okay, so while my chicken is cooking outside, I come inside and prep the steaks. Once the steaks are prepped, I'll do the vegetables and throw them in the steamer, and it's just like this perfect system that just works. So the timing is perfect. I can cook the chicken, prep the steaks, flip the chicken, prep the vegetables, and everything doesn't get overcooked and everything gets done. So similar, I don't know if you can see me, similar to the chicken, all we do, olive oil first, spread it all around, and then we're going to go Montreal steak spice. Boom. It's all you need, guys. I'm telling you. This light's not good. Well. All right, put your olive oil on first. Both sides. Get it everywhere on the steaks. Montreal steak spice. Sort of pat it in a little bit. Flip and repeat. That's it. They're ready to go. Got the chickens going. Look pretty good. I'm gonna give them a flip right now. It's so bright out here. Okay, broccoli now. What I do is I turn this tap on. I have my steamer down here, and I literally just take a knife and just chop the broccoli down into it, and it's so easy. Watch, boom, they all come apart right in there. No screwing around, they're done. See how fast that is? So how do you know when the chicken's done? That is the big question. I just do it from experience, really. Like, what I do is I sort of grab it and I squeeze it. I can feel if it's done or not. Like you can feel like it's really, really squishy if it's not done. It's just more one of those things that you just gotta experiment with and then play around, cut into one, see what it feels like, and then do it again. You'll get the hang of it. So I'm just gonna do a trial right now just to see if this one is ready. That's pretty much the biggest breast that was in there. So we're gonna cut into it and see how we did. Beautiful. There's no pink in it. It looks and smells perfect. All right, now we're good to go with the steaks. So while the chicken breast is cooling down, the broccoli is cooking. Got the steaks going on. This is how easy it is, guys. This is how easy it is, I'm telling you. I'm able to vlog this whole thing and still be efficient. So tell me why again you don't have enough time to meal prep. For my steaks, do about a minute on, flip them. Then they're gonna be about another 2 minutes on that side. Quarter turn them.